Opening a cafe in the middle of a pandemic was a risk worth taking for Barbara and John-Paul. A chance at a new life here in Whitehead. But just weeks after opening, their business and home came under attack.
When I came down here last night, I thought that they'd just thrown at our front door, and that had sickened me. But when I came round and I saw that this had happened, I felt like I had been punched.
This is just so disgusting. I hope that you're happy. I hope that you've got the reaction that
you won.
Wanted.
You broke us. You done it. You know, we're broken.
Police are treating this attack as a hate crime. John-Paul believes it's the physical manifestation of years of online trolling after he revealed his involvement with a satirical website called Loyalists Against Democracy, more commonly known as LAD, a platform he says he severed ties with back in 2016.
The last 4 years have been a transformational process in my life. You know, I'm sober and I'm healthy and I'm alive. Despite numerous attempts for that not to be the case, you know, I'm still here and I am contrite in my genuine apology to anybody affected by anything that I said or was said in my name. I don't know what we're going to do. Like, there's a temptation to pack our bags and run away. You know, there is a temptation to do that.
We have our son to think about. And we have it's not only that, it's the responsibility of our team.
And despite being told to take the day off, that team came in today for the cleanup, determined to restore this building back to its former glory. This building is over 100 years old. Locals say the window that was targeted is older than the Titanic itself. But to the Whearties, it represented a new beginning. The only comfort they can find today is knowing that the people of Whitehead are behind them.
I'm very saddened. You know, I've lived here for 30 years. I think it's very unrepresentative of how Whitehead ticks.
I'm absolutely shocked with what has happened. Very disappointed. I can't believe that such, I'll call it intimidation.
While the future of this cafe remains unclear, Barbara and John-Paul say they're determined to fight for their business. Eden Wilson, UTV Live.